Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you all are fine and safe by the grace of God. Welcome back to Science Online class. Children, in the previous class, we have learned egg-laying animals and the life cycle of egg-laying animals such as hen and frog. Isn't it? Hope you all have learned that portions. Children, today we shall continue the remaining portion. Okay. First, we can learn the life cycle of a butterfly. Children, you all have seen butterflies, isn't it? Do you know how do they reproduce? Butterflies reproduce by laying eggs. They lay eggs on the lower side of leaves. Egg hatches and the young one that comes out does not resemble a butterfly at all. Instead, it looks like a worm. This worm is called larva or caterpillar. The caterpillar feeds continuously on the leaves and grows rapidly. After some days, it stops eating and starts building a covering called cocoon around itself. This is called pupa stage. The larva keeps growing inside the cocoon until it develops into an adult butterfly. This is done by shedding its skin. So, this process of shedding the old skin is called molting. What is molting? The process of shedding the old skin is called molting. After some time, the cocoon splits open and the butterfly comes out of it. Okay. Have you all understood? Children, the larva of a housefly is called a maggot. A baby cockroach is called a nymph. Children, do you know who is known as the butterfly man of India? Isaac David Himker is known as the butterfly man of India. He has spent a lifetime studying butterflies and nature. He has written many books on butterflies and won many awards for his work. He is working to popularize the concept of butterfly gardens to enable butterflies and moths to live in cities. Okay. Next, we can learn the another method of reproduction in animals, that is by giving birth to young ones. Okay. Children, do all animals lay eggs? No, isn't it? Some animals do not lay eggs. Then how do they reproduce? They reproduce by giving birth to young ones that feed on their mother's milk. So, animals that give birth to young ones are called mammals. What are mammals? Animals that give birth to young ones are called mammals. Mammals are examples of such animals. Mammals have well-developed brains. Most mammals have hair on their body. Human beings, along with dog, cat, lion, elephant, deer, cow, buffalo, hippopotamus, zebra, giraffe, monkey, and rabbit are some examples of mammals. Whales and dolphins are mammals found in water, but they do not have hair on their body. Most mammals live on land and breathe through lungs. Do you know how a whale or a dolphin breathes? Whales and dolphins also breathe through lungs. They take in air through blowholes present on the top of their heads. Hence, they have to come to the surface of water frequently to breathe in air. Okay. Some mammals such as duck-billed platypus and spiny anteater do not give birth to babies. They lay eggs instead. Okay. Children, who look after you? Your parents, isn't it? Just as our parents look after us, all other mammals look after their babies. Most of them build houses to protect their babies from enemies and also hunt for food. The mother feeds her babies her own milk. She cleans them and keeps them warm. Okay. Whether birds look after their babies? Yes, birds too look after their babies. They build nests to keep them warm. Since the chicks cannot fly, parent birds get food for their chicks and also protect them from any danger. Okay, children? Take your science booklet and write the question answer. Already we have completed 3 questions. Now write the 4th one. Define molting, the process of shedding the old skin is called molting. I repeat, define molting, the process of shedding the old skin is called molting. 5th one. What are mammals? Write 2 characteristic features of mammals. Animals which reproduce by giving birth to young ones are called mammals. Mammals have very well developed brains. Mothers feed their young ones with their milk. I repeat, what are mammals? Write 2 characteristic features of mammals. Animals which reproduce by giving birth to young ones are called mammals. Mammals have very well developed brains. Mothers feed their young ones with their milk. Next Roman letter 2. Answer in detail. First one. Write a short note on the life cycle of a hen. The mother hen lays eggs in her nest and sits on them to keep them warm. Once the embryo within the egg has developed into a chick, the chick breaks the shell to come out. The young chick then grows up to become an adult hen. I repeat, write a short note on the life cycle of a hen. The mother hen lays eggs in her nest and sits on them to keep them warm. Once the embryo within the egg has developed into a chick, the chick breaks the shell to come out. The young chick then grows up to become an adult hen. Okay. Now we shall do some book exercise. Take page number 101. First, fill in the blanks with the correct words. First one, birds reproduce by dash, laying eggs, L-A-Y-I-N-G, laying, E-G-G-S, eggs. Second, birds build nest on trees to dash their eggs, lay,
L-A-Y, lay. Third, the yellow inner part of the egg is the dash. Answer is yolk. Y-O-L-K, yolk. Fourth one, dash helps the embryo inside the egg to develop better and faster. Answer is warmth. W-A-R-M-T-H, warmth. Fifth one, a frog lays eggs in large clusters called dash. Answer is spawns. S-P-A-W-N-S, spawns. Sixth one, most mammals have dash on their bodies. Answer is hair. H-A-I-R, hair. Next, choose the correct option. First one, which of these parts is rich in protein? Option A, eggshell. B, yolk. C, albumen. D, all of this. Answer is option C, albumen. Second one, which of these animals lay eggs to reproduce? Option A, birds and insects. Option B, turtles and lizards. Option C, frogs and crocodiles. Option D, all of this. Answer is option D, all of this. Third one, when an animal undergoes several changes through its growing process, it is said to have undergone dash. Option A, molting. Option B, metamorphosis. Option C, maggot. Option D, spawns. Answer is option B, metamorphosis. Fourth one, which of these is not a part of the life cycle of a butterfly? Option A, the adult lays eggs in large clusters called spawns. Option B, the pupa changes into an adult. Option C, the caterpillar sheds its skin and forms a pupa. Option D, all of this. Answer is option A, the adult lays eggs in large clusters called spawns. Fifth one, which of these mammals do not have hair on their bodies? Option A, elephant and giraffe. Option B, giraffe and zebra. Option C, lion and tiger. Option D, whale and dolphin. Answer is option D, whale and dolphin. Sixth one, which of these refers to large clusters in which a frog lays eggs? Option A, tadpole. Option B, spawn. Option C, molting. Option D, metamorphosis. Answer is option B, spawn. Seventh one, which of these stages does the caterpillar belong to? Option A, larva. Option B, pupa. Option C, adult. Option D, none of this. Answer is option A, larva. Eighth one, which of these is not true about mammals? Option A, they have hair on their skin. Option B, they have well-developed brains. Option C, they mostly multiply by giving birth to young ones. Option D, none of this. Answer is option D, none of these. Next, give one word for the following. First one, the ability to produce more of their own kind. Answer is reproduction. R-E-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N, reproduction. Second one, various stages of development from an embryo to a mature adult in the life of an animal. Answer is life cycle. L-I-F-E, life. C-Y-C-L-E, cycle, life cycle. Third one, a complete change from a young form to an adult form. Answer is metamorphosis. M-E-T-A-M-O-R-P-H-O-S-I-S, metamorphosis. Fourth one, the process of shedding the old skin by an animal. Answer is molting. M-O-U-L-T-I-N-G, molting. Fifth one, animals that reproduce by giving birth to young ones who feed on their mother's milk. Answer is mammals. M-A-M-M-A-L-S, mammals. Next, give two examples for each of the following. First one, egg-laying animals. Answer is lizard, crocodile. LIZARD, lizard. CROCODILE, crocodile. Second one, animals that undergo metamorphosis. Frog, butterfly. FROG, frog. BUTTERFLY, butterfly. Third, animals that give birth to young ones. Cat, deer. CAT, cat. DEER, deer. Fourth one, mammals. Answer is dog, elephant. DOG, dog. ELEPHANT, elephant. Fifth one, mammals found in water. Whale, dolphin. WHALE, whale. DOLPHIN, dolphin. Okay, children.
With this, I finish today's session. We shall learn a new lesson in the next class. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.